do this. Drowning in the same. If anyone can remember why the hell I'm here. Trying to track down Livia Drusilla. Well, her identity anyway.
I suppose you're going to follow me around this entire trip.
That's what I'm here for, Mr. Rector.
Well, I certainly hope Dexter's private plane was able to shake any pursuers. It would be nice to only have to think about my job for a change, rather than being attacked.
You worry about your job, sir. I'll take care of the rest.
He's ever so formal, isn't he? When in doubt, drug up. So, Caroline Alphonse. I have a dossier on my phone. Okay. So, let's see what we have to say about her. The daughter of wealthy businessman Henri Alphonse, Caroline is descended from both the Capetians and the Bourbons. Determine if Caroline's life pattern fits that of Livia Drusilla. Contact details, Bibliothèque Nationale. Okay, and I know nothing about her as yet, so. Fun.
What have I got to find out who Captain Walker really is. I've started this dossier.
Okay. Haha, that'll be interesting. I only have 4 data points thus far. He's a nice guy and scary. So, Mobius theory. The principle behind this entire situation. So, history has defined patterns which repeat themselves over and over. Space-time is not linear. Energy patterns play out in one moment of time, rippling or echoing out across the fourth dimension. Basically, there's a limited amount of memory space, and we're all working off cache copies. Yay. And I think I can do with just turning up their audio a bit. Right. So, it's a plant.
Plants are real and not overly gaudy, which is more than I can say for most of the tourists staying here.
Beverly?
There's something significant about Captain Walker that I'm missing. I need to see if he has an historical pattern, the way Senator Markham does.
I need to see if I can say the word historical.
Mr. Walker?
Yes, Mr. Rector.
Tell me about your time in the Army.
What do you want to know, Mr. Rector?
How old were you when you joined?
20. I knew I wanted to join the military, but if I finished college first, I could enlist as an officer. So I did. I enlisted as a second lieutenant right after graduation.
How long were you in the military?
10 years.
You look about 12.
Why did you leave the military?
I spent the last 18 months of my service training foreign armies to disable protesters. Their own people. I couldn't do it anymore. It's getting really bad out there.
No worse than it's always been.
No, trust me. It's worse.
What did you study in college?
I have a BA in military history.
Well, that's shocking.
You said you were from Indiana. Did you grow up there?
Yes, I grew up in a small town. Didn't leave it until I went to college.
You've never heard of an agency called FETA?
Not until you took me there. I've made a few phone calls. None of my buddies have heard of them either. They seem to excel at staying under the radar. So, I take it you're supposed to identify a woman who might become Senator Markham's wife, and this is somehow tied to a Roman emperor.
Hello, Hint Fishy.
I don't suppose you'd care to enlighten me.
I am properly streaming now. I'm interrogating David. If you're on stream, Fish, any chance you could tell me how the sound's coming over, because I had to play Silly Bugger slightly. and I want to know if I've gone too far the other way. Oh, do I trust him? Do I not trust him? That's a complicated question. I think
here's
I trust him.
What I know.
So, Senator Markham is supposed to be Augustus, and if he marries the right woman, he'll become president and save the global economy?
If you take the Mobius theory seriously, yes. Or at least, he has that potential.
Do you trust the Mobius theory?
It seems absurd, but my... let's just say I can't entirely dismiss it.
Thank you for telling me.
Probably not the smartest thing I've ever done.
You told me because you know you can trust me. And you can.
I don't trust anyone.
Yes, sir.
I just wanted to make sure that my twiddling with my audio hadn't gone too far the other way, because I was too loud yesterday, and I wanted to make sure I wasn't too loud now, too quiet now, but now I am fine. Everything looks like it's good. And Malachi has just decided that he trusts David, which I'm not entirely sure is my smartest move ever. Because he's an untrusting soul.
Tell me about your family.
I have one sister. She's married and lives in Ohio.
And your parents?
They're still living.
Okay, and that's as much information as that you're going to get out of him.
What about a wife or a girlfriend?
I haven't been in one place long enough to have a relationship.
I'm still fairly sure that wives and girlfriends are out of luck. I could do with a touch more of me, can I? Well, that's not something somebody says often. So let's nudge it up a tiny bit. Oh, yes. Okay. Let's call that even. Tell me a joke.
I don't suppose you have any more brilliant jokes.
Hell yeah. What's brown and sticky?
Do tell.
A stick.
It's not really funny, is it?
No, it's not. It really, really isn't. It's rock, isn't it? Okay, having my mic anywhere near my mouth would probably ban. Three stream fishy.
Did you hear about the Buddhist at Yankee Stadium?
No.
He asked the hot dog vendor to make him one with everything.
Ow.
Yes, I see.
Tough crowd. Why were the journalists all gathered around the crater?
What crater?
It's just a hole in the ground. Doesn't matter.
Of course it matters.
It really doesn't.
Fine. Why were the journalists all gathered around the crater?
They were hoping for a story that was a little meteor.
I see.
Ouch.
Are all these jokes of yours word puns?
Pretty much, yeah.
I'm not sure I can cope with this, but...
Why was the skeleton lonely?
He was bony. No, that's not right. He was skulking?
Nope. Nice try, though. He was lonely because he had no body.
Oh, God, that's pathetic.
Great, isn't it? What did the pâté say to the stuck-up filet mignon?
I wait breathlessly for the answer.
What do I look like? Chopped liver?
Ouch!
Liked that one, did you?
I'm laughing, but no. Hang on, have I just got points for going through the full run of bad
That's
jokes?
That's all for now.
As you say, sir.
Right. Let's do some research into the people I am supposed to, well, the person I'm supposed to be.
I haven't heard of Montfroy. Must be information about him somewhere. This biography is very basic. According to the Mobius info from Dexter, Rerik was the founding father of the modern Mobius theory and worked for the British.
As you do. Right. Dossier. How many data points did that... Oh, that gave me 10 data points. Okay. What does that give me? I'm married at 31. I like pointsforpuns.com. That needs to be a thing. Okay. Potentially valid. St. Martin of Tours. Unlikely. Sir Galahad. I'm not entirely sure that he's chaste and virtuous, you know. Could be anything. Several siblings. Well, I think we can knock him out. Richard the First. Multiple siblings. Joan of Arc. Multiple siblings and a girl. Briefly, the King of England was a tosser. Definitely not. Sir Thomas Hardy. Small town. Again, small town. Sir Galahad. Raised in a nunnery by his aunt. Well, so, no. Roderick Butler. Now, we've got a few options, but I don't think we have... I think we need that final data point to really get somewhere. So, let's have a look around this place.
The furniture is entirely modern, even if it does have a hint of classic style.
Good God, man, you are such a snob. I love you.
Four coffee cups, I suppose. There's a counter for adding cream and sugar to your coffee.
Fair enough.
Parisians love their coffee, and it's usually excellent. The barista. He has an elaborate neck tattoo.
Ganged up! He's a ganger.
Plants are real and not overly gaudy, which is more than I can say for most of the tourists staying here.
He really just doesn't do people at all, does he? Right. Let's analyse the barista, just because I haven't done that. Ooh. Thinks they look cool. Style conscious, but not well off. No, he just does not strike me as a gang. Mark, come to my stream. Abandon Aurorus. It's me being in the evil. Obsessed with death. Possibly. Symbol has meaning to the wearer. Well, if somebody tattoos their neck, I sincerely hope it does have meaning to them. He does not look like a fighter. Don't think you cut yourself making coffee. The idea of this guy doing extreme sports is just a bit new. Gym rat would be bigger, male model possibly, but if he does extreme sports... Barista and a student and daredevil. The barista does some manner of extreme sports and his tattoo has a personal meaning to him. Okay. Doesn't actually help me at all, but you know. Right. Ooh, so many decisions. Let's go to the library first. Get some research in.
There's nothing in the book drop.
Okay.
It looks like that book drop is for the archives. I'll bet they have some fascinating historic documents in there.
Uh-huh.
Those computers appear to be for public use.
Okay.
This is the famous reading room of Richelieu. It's quite beautiful. The main library is much more modern in appearance.
Right. Library. Because of course you do. You go bin diving as soon as you go
somewhere.
Whoever
was drinking that coffee wears a vile shade of orange lipstick. I don't have any use for those dregs of coffee.
It's My Little Pony, apparently. Okay.
The head librarian, I presume. She has an interesting fashion sense.
You could be Katia if you put
There's
your mind to it.
There's a post-it note on her monitor, but I can't see what it says.
She's using Windows. I can see it out from here.
I don't think the librarian would appreciate it if I took her post-it note.
Save the world. Steal a post-it note. Okay. Before I go talk to her... Oh, dear. Charming child. Cold, disinterested eyes. Could be anything. Let's go with the mouth. Trying to draw attention to her lips. No fashion sense. Uptight, rule enforcer. Oh yes, she is. She was born to be a librarian. She's uptight, she wears bright colours, and she's trying to draw attention to her lips. I'm going with sexually frustrated. We know she drinks coffee. Let's go with that one, because I don't remember her. Yes, definitely not for him. But I do know a blonde, if I can persuade him to so do.
It's strange having someone follow me everywhere.
Oops.
But given what happened in Cairo, I don't have much choice. I don't have anything to say to Mr.
Okay. Let's see if I can get anywhere.
Excuse me?
Yes? May I help you?
I'm looking for information on Caroline Alphonse. Newspaper articles, a biography, things of that nature.
If you mean the current Caroline Alphonse, she's much too young to have a biography. But there should be clippings from the press. Take computer number 2 at the table over there. I'll send you what I find.
Thank you.
Do you have any information about Benedict de Montfroy?
Let me look that up. There is something in the private archives, but access to that material is by invitation only.
I'll pay. What's the fee?
There is no fee. You must apply for a special grant and demonstrate the need for access. The process takes weeks.
Oh.
Would you care to fill out the form?
Nope.
No, that won't be necessary. Damn French bureaucracy.
Oh, Malachi in the strop.
Is there a place to get coffee around here?
Unfortunately, no. I wish there was.
Thanks for your help.
You're welcome.
You're in France and you're not in range of a coffee place. What is this strange universe? Right, let's go have a look at the computer. I'm getting buffering now. However, let's just assume that this is going through okay and it's simply Twitch is being a git. I don't think there is actually. I think it's just Malachi. Sorry. Archives. Need a password.
Caroline was engaged to a 43-year-old man when she was just 19.
Right. Definitely like their elder men. Okay. Senator Gérard de Villiers. I make no apology for my French accent. It's awful.
Caroline's parents divorced when she was still a teenager.
Worth knowing.
Interesting. Caroline's fiancé called off the engagement. I wonder why. I'll take a photo of these in case I need to reference them later.
Please do. I thought it was just me who screenshots everything. Right, that's it. I need that information. What, the buffering? Yes.
I need you to flirt with a librarian for me. Distract her.
Sorry. My job description doesn't include being pimped out.
I didn't ask for you to sleep with her. Just flirt with a woman.
You don't just flirt with a librarian. I'll need some reason to approach her.
You're horny.
Not that reason. Give me a good reason or forget it.
Let's go with please. Actually, let's go with...
I think I know whose coffee this is. I'd like a closer look.
My French accent. This is the problem, you see. I've played Broken Sword games for way too long. Which, yes, are on my stream list at some stage if I can persuade them to work. Oi, no switchy offy. Okay, nope, still only got 5 data points. Not worth mucking about. I know where I can get coffee. Wrong yaw, dear. Right. La Belle Eiffel. So, let's have a look at the coffee.
The orange lipstick on that coffee cup is familiar. There's just enough left in the cup for me to get a sample.
Yummy.
The orange lipstick on...
Oh. Right.
The barista. I suppose I could buy a coffee for someone else.
Which bit convinced you of his insanity? The stealing the coffee cup or attempting to analyze the contents?
S'il vous plaît.
Un moment. €3, please.
Merci.
€3 for a cup of coffee. Okay. So, let's have a look.
It's rather tan. It definitely has some cream in it.
Okay. We'll never know what's in that one. We know what's in this one. That's disgusting. Looks about right to me.
It's rather tan.
Yeah, I know.
It tastes sweet.
Ew.
Far too sweet for my palate.
Oh, come on. It came from a bin.
It's not quite sweet enough.
Uh-huh. Let's check.
I think the coffee is correct now, but perhaps I should dress it up a bit.
It's got to be.
I suppose these are for making shapes in the foam on your coffee. How unsanitary.
Just rude. Right. I think it's going to be the heart cutter. Aww. Little love hearts.
This should appeal to a lonely librarian.
You're just mean. Really? In what possible context? They're short on coffee?
This should appeal.
Oops.
This should appeal to a.
Alright, okay. Out we go. We assume he takes it with him. Which he does. Let's assume he also has a lid. Silence in the library. And other Doctor Who episodes. Walker. Give her a coffee, for God's sake. Oops, wrong one. Is this your empty cup of coffee?
I need you to distract the librarian. Give her this coffee and be friendly, all right?
Friendly. Yeah, distract her over there. Do you take one dose of a hypnol or two? And the post-it note will be mine. He's a very accommodating bodyguard. I'm still fairly sure, however, that she's out of luck. Okay. Password is...
It's the password from the librarian's desk.
Fair enough. Time to go use the password. Malachi broken his leg. Benedict de Montfort. Okay, well, you're better looking than he is. Abbot of one of the largest monasteries in France. His intellect was beyond all other men. He could remember the exact details of anything he'd seen or read decades later. Records and accounts from his monastery portray him as cruel and exacting. Oops. Plagued with demonic attacks. His journals recount terrible headaches and what modern medicine would identify as seizures, which he suffered in private. Monastery records show his health improved in later years rather than declining with age. He worked diligently as a scholar, but his work was never made public, even after he was burned at the stake. Hello. Along with his close associate, Saint-Armand. Who is Saint-Armand?
Got it.
Fairly sure you're not supposed to do that. Can I get anything out of Saint-Armand? Oops. Plagued with demonic attacks. His journals recount terrible headaches and what modern medicine would identify as seizures, which he suffered in private. Monastery records show his health improved in later years rather than declining with age. He worked diligently as a scholar, but his work was never made public, even after he was burned at the stake. Hello. Along with his close associate, Saint-Armand. Who is Saint-Armand?
Got it.
Fairly sure you're not supposed to do that. Can I get anything out of Saint-Armand? That's the question. Archives. Thank you.
Good. I just need to pick it up.
Now, is that in Neverwinter or is that in this? Because burned at the stake really doesn't sound like a good fate. I'm kind of keen on avoiding that. Ah. Saint Armand, one of many knights of the Crusades. It's bloody Crusaders again. Praised Imperial ballads, but most noteworthy for his long friendship with and personal protector of the Abbot Benedict de Montfort. Okay. Close personal friend of de Montfort. Ah, interesting. So apparently burned at the stake, except that he wasn't.
I wonder why Saint-Armand was so loyal to Montfort. It couldn't have been for money. Montfort was a mere abbot.
I think you may
this
be onto something.
This says he's buried in the Paris catacombs. I'd like to see that.
Okay. And David's clearly given
Got
up.
It.
Let's just, for completeness sake, have a proper look at the...
It's a page on Benedict de Montfort from the Paris archives.
Okay. You get anywhere? All right then. Right. I have no idea yet how to get in, so... Let's go and check out the person I'm actually supposed to be investigating.
Good afternoon. I'm Malachi Rector, and this is my associate, Mr. Walker. We're here to see Caroline Alphonse.
Please, come in. I am Brett, house manager for the Alphonse family. I received a call from the consulate that you were coming, but I'm afraid you must be disappointed. Caroline and her father are away for the weekend. However, I am at your service, monsieur.
Thank you, Brett.
Trust you as far as I can comfortably spit a rat. Trust you enough, in fact, to save the game.
He says he's the house manager. I suppose that's something like a butler or a PA. The mirror appears to be broke, but I should take a closer look. This is a terrible forgery. I can see the seams of the plastic frame under the gold paint.
Hello, fishy.
Horrendous.
Okay. If it's bad enough that he doesn't even have to go into analysis mode, you've got problems.
The clock looks genuine, but I should analyze it. It's a genuine antique long case grandfather clock, 19th century.
Okay.
That appears to be a Chinese Ming vase.
He's a very distrustful.
It's a fake, and not a very good one. It appears to be a Chinese gold urn. It's gold leaf, and the urn itself is a modern replica.
Ooh.
Tacky.
See, this is a problem because, you know, we're supposed to be talking wealthy family.
That's
here.
An impressive piece of sculpture for a sitting room. It looks like Amadeo Modigliani.
Yep, I think... you know what, I can seriously see him doing that. He makes Sheldon look like nothing.
The signature is wrong, and on closer inspection, the work is hasty. This is a fake.
Grief. Okay, that's a box of tissues. Apparently he doesn't feel the
need to
analyze
that. Those are modern ceramics. Nothing special. The sofa and chairs are 19th century Italian. Good pieces.
Oh, they're genuine.
The furniture is just as it appears to be. They're sturdy pieces, but not particularly rare.
Yellow McAdoy. I'm analysing furniture.
The globe looks like a 14th century antique. I can't be sure, though, without studying it closely.
Time to hit the analysis. We're just going to wander around, ignore you completely, Brett, and just check out your furniture.
This isn't a 14th century globe. It's a knockoff. Not even a very good one.
Ooh.
Those books appear to be old, from a distance.
Well, given this, we're probably talking charity shop circa 1992. Yes, I don't even have chatty running.
First editions, some of them quite fragile. The books are authentic.
Oh. Okay.
that appears to be an Empire mantle clock, a fairly valuable antique. That black lacquer is modern, and the gold is fake. It's a forgery.
Basically, about half the stuff here is knockoff.
That fireplace is original to the house.
Thank God.
Very nice.
Yes, there appear to be people in my chat, but I ought to investigate further.
That mirror looks like a remarkable piece, but I should get closer.
You're 2 feet away. Come on, Malachi.
The mirror is Swedish Rococo, dated to the mid-1700s. Made by Niklas Meunier. Very nice.
Okay, so you found something you like.
That's a burled wood cabinet.
Is it genuine?
An 18th century burled wood cabinet.
Cool.
The decorations indicate it was made here in Paris. It's genuine and worth at least $5,000.
I've seen salvage hunters, you know. It's probably worth more if it's battered and has a dodgy paint job.
Those doors are exceptional. The house is well maintained.
Right. Butler. Ooh, he's sweating. I don't see him running everywhere, anywhere. So I think he's nervous. Shifty eyes. Yeah. Something in the room is distracting him. He has an eye twitch, or David's presence gives him butterflies. Well, it's understandable. He's a very attractive man. But, let's go with something's distracting him. It could be that, or it could be that. I'm not sure which. Hides his hands in his pockets. Hiding poorly groomed nails. Hiding something. Subconscious tell. Let's go with that. The guy's nervous. But it's very nervous about something in this room that he wishes to remain hidden or secret. Is it perhaps the fact that half the antiques in here aren't? Let's have a chat. Hypothetically.
Do you know what I find fascinating about this room?
What is that?
The astounding number of fake antiques. How long have you been stealing from the Alphonse family, Brett?
It's not true.
Come now. These aren't your ordinary knockoffs. These are fakes meant to replace very specific and valuable pieces. You've been having the fakes made and replacing them one by one. I don't suppose anyone in the family is smart enough to realize it.
No, I do it for Madeleine's sake. Henri cheated her in the divorce. She got almost nothing. She needed my help. Caroline knows about it and she approves. But not Henri. Please, do not tell him, monsieur. He will throw me out and make sure no one will hire me.
I may be able to hold my tongue. But you'll need to be much more accommodating.
Oui, monsieur. Anything.
Diplomacy, Malachi Rector style. Threaten your livelihood.
How did Henri avoid paying Madeleine a divorce settlement? The papers indicated that he'd been unfaithful and violated the prenup.
I do not know. Madeleine said he made it look like he had no money. He must have hidden it. But Madeleine's lawyer was unable to prove such a thing. It may have something to do with Henri's business partner, Etienne. I do not trust that man.
Nope, I don't trust him either, on general principle. Don't trust anybody called Etienne. Go buffer a go-go. Right, let's get down to the meat of things.
Tell me about Caroline Alphonse.
She is very special, intelligent, beautiful and kind. She is the crème de la crème in every way.
Yes, I'll quite happily place all of the stars with you two. I mean, obviously I will get my ass kicked. You're getting steam, friends. You must be one of the cool kids. Yes. I wish that I could be like the cool kids. Yes, Twitch is basically being a bit of a pig. I hope it's back.
Tell me about Caroline's father, Henri.
Henri is a very important man. But you must know this already, eh?
Exceptional businessman, doting father, pillar of the community, etc., etc. Is that about it?
So you say, monsieur. I'm sure you know best.
Tell me more about Etienne.
He is Henri's business partner, a very sharp man, but I do not like him. The way he looks at Caroline, it is not right.
You make Caroline sound like quite the paragon. But I read that her fiancé broke off the engagement. Do you know why?
I do not gossip about the family, monsieur, but that man, he was an idiot.
Someone's got a crush on Caroline.
Did you know Caroline's mother, Madeleine?
Naturellement. I have served the family for 15 years. I was here when Madeleine was still in the house. She is a beautiful and gracious woman.
Sounds like you quite liked Madeleine. Is that why they divorced?
Ridiculous gossip.
Thank you for the image of Fishy wearing a baseball cap back to front. At least I hope you meant back to front, not his backside to front, because that would just be rude. And either way, I'm probably going to end up having to get him sectioned. Whoops!
When Madeleine left, you stayed with Henri. You prefer him, do you?
She is not able to pay me, or she would have taken me with her, monsieur. I told you she got almost nothing in the divorce.
I want to know where Caroline is and when she'll be back.
Caroline won't be back until Monday night. She did not tell me where she was going, but I had the feeling it was a lover's rendezvous. One she was not looking forward to.
Oh, okay.
I'd like to see Caroline's room now.
Very well, monsieur. I will take you there.
Oh, you have to stream Shadowrun with your flat cap on tomorrow. Back to front. Let's save this, because, you know, paranoia. Okay, this appears to be a bed. I should look at it
closer. Caroline's bed looks undisturbed.
Caroline's bed looks completely unslept in ever.
This room has a remarkable view of Paris.
It's in Paris. It would be strange if it had a remarkable view of Berlin.
Caroline has a degree in economics from l'École Normale Supérieure de Paris. That's a prestigious university.
Yes, of course. It's very much a British sort of thing.
It's a book about the Paris catacombs. Caroline must be interested in the subject.
Okay. Could you just sort of take an entire copy of that, please? They suit Fishy. They kind of don't suit me, I have to say. I look much, much better in my fedora.
It's a book about the pen.
No, okay. Any other books on this shelf? No, we're still going for the same book. Okay, I notice a pattern emerging here. So let's just assume. Bookcase, bookcase, bookcase. David, what
not
do you
here.
Think?
For all I know, this room could be bugged.
Oh, you're not paranoid enough! Yeah, that one died after it went through the wash, didn't it? Now it looks like a baseball cap.
This room has a remarkable view of Paris.
Okay.
These are all current event and economic magazines. Caroline must have an interest in politics.
Yeah, which is in her favour for the whole Livia Drusilla thing, but she hasn't been married.
I don't need to take those magazines with me.
I just want you to look at them. Okay.
That dresser is one of the better pieces in the house. There's nothing in there except women's clothing. Don't even go there.
You've got issues, Malachi. The GMing, Fez.
That's an exceptional mural.
Okay. Huh. Whee! Okay. Anything more you want to talk to me about, Mr. Butler, sir? Oh, that doesn't shock me.
That's all for the moment.
Oui, monsieur.
I need somebody who can tell me about the catacombs. I wonder if the librarian can. Talk to me.
Excuse me.
Yes, may I help you?
Excuse me.
Oui.
I read that there's a medieval knight named Saint-Armand buried in the Paris catacombs. Do you have any information on how I could go see that?
Let me check for you. Yes, Saint-Armand is called the Knight of the Catacombs, but I'm afraid the section where he's buried is off limits to the public.
You're joking.
Pas de tout. There are over 200 kilometers of tunnels and mines under Paris. Very dangerous. Only a small part of the catacombs is open to the public. You can find tourist brochures in the lobby.
Damn it!
Oh, Malachi, have a strop.
The Paris catacombs sound fascinating. You wouldn't have some old maps I could peruse? Purely for the purpose of research, of course.
It is illegal to go into the underground. All of our maps have been removed from circulation.
You just... fine.
Yes.
Thanks for your help.
You are welcome.
It's a version of chaotic evil. It's actually mad evil. Medieval. Yep, that works too. It's halfway between neutral and chaotic. Yep. Okay, damn it. Okay. No brochures available. I need somebody who's going to tell me about the dodgy catacombs? What the hell's a catacomb? Catacombs.
I had coffee this morning. Too much isn't good for my anxiety disorder.
Helpful, thank you.
Mr. Walker?
Yes, Mr. Rector.
That's all for now.
As you say, sir.
Hmm. Okay, what have I got?
There's something significant about Captain Walker that I'm missing. I need to see if he has an historical pattern, the way Senator Markham
does. You really can't say historical. Okay, let's see if I can get anything on analysis this time. Caroline Alphonse, only 7 data points. Still on the 10 for him. You see, I've just got this distinct feeling that we are talking Saint-Armand. Yeah. But I can't confirm that without all the data points. No cease and desist order. Does extreme sports? I know that
the barista
is.
He has an elaborate neck tattoo. I had coffee that.
Nope. Okay.
Mr. Rector, come in.
Thank you.
Please don't get me fired. Anything else to tell me?
That's all for the...
Oui, monsieur.
He does not look like the sort who'd be going swanning around Paris catacombs.
This room has a remarkable view of Paris.
Oh, hello.
That head looks Victorian, but it's not a very attractive or valuable piece. I wonder why she keeps it.
Nah-huh. You're not going to analyze it?
That's excellent work. I didn't even notice the seam.
Nice.
I need the combination. It looks like it's six numbers. Perhaps a date.
Ooh. Okay, what have we got? Let's have a look. 200808.
That did it.
I'm impressed. So you're a codebreaker too?
Hardly.
Yay. It was going to be the date of her graduation or the date of her parents' divorce. It's a bit maudlin though. What you got?
The date on that note is this weekend. That must be where Caroline is staying. I need to see her in person.
Now, apparently this book on the catacombs doesn't have a map of the catacombs, which would be extremely useful. Although I'm going to go and have a poke at it in a minute.
That's an accounting ledger. I wonder why it's in the safe.
Because it's accounting and it's private? Quick, nick it. Hello, envelope.
The ledger's for the family's finances. Caroline appears to be very involved in the running of the estate. These numbers don't look good. I need to speak with Caroline.
She is looking less and less like Livia Drusilla as we go.
It's a letter to Caroline from her ex-fiancé.
Oh. Since learning the true state of things, I must break off our engagement. You're a lovely girl, but we both know there were certain practicalities to the arrangement.
I wonder what practicalities her fiancé is talking about. Was it related to virginity? Infertility? Scandal? Money?
Basically do like digging into other people's lives, don't you, dear? Oh, okay. Apparently we're just going to leave that open. That book on the catacombs. Is there anything I can do with it?
It's a book about the Paris catacombs. It doesn't mention Saint-Armand, unfortunately.
That's at least the fourth pronunciation for Saint-Armand.
I wonder why Caroline is interested in the catacombs.
Ask her?
I don't need to take those magazines with me.
But I want to! Let me, damn you.
We can go. I've gotten everything I can from this room.
Oh, yes,
I hate
you did.
The term gotten.
I can see why Dexter considers you a prime asset.
What do you mean by that?
A prime asset is someone of military or political importance. Someone who has a unique skill. Someone worth protecting at any cost.
I'm not sure I'd like guarding a person like
good
that.
Good night, Mechador.
Someone has to. Let's go.
Sleep well. Okay. Let's hope I have a new I have a new location. Let's go to the chateau.
Caroline Alphonse, another lovely young woman with an impeccable pedigree. But is she Livia Drusilla?
Oh dear, now you've left David completely out in the cold.
He looks particularly ominous in this pastoral setting, doesn't he?
The term is pastoral, dear.
I've never been partial to oddly shaped shrubberies. This place is exceptionally private. It seems to cater to VIPs who don't want to be found.
Well, that's a shame. I found her. That's a table.
It's a pleasant enough day for sitting outside.
But I should analyze it first.
The garden is surprisingly subtle, except for those flowers. I approve. I don't think Caroline would be swayed by flowers, and I have no one else to give them to.
Give them to David! That's random.
The lanterns are a romantic touch.
Apparently I can steal a lantern. Where are you keeping that? That's worse than the boat hook.
It's a lantern and matches.
Okay. As you do.
Caroline Alphon.
Oh, whoops. Analysis. Sharp, unfriendly expression. Nobody likes you, Malachi. I'm not sure you can judge by expression. Uncomfortable or proud and regal. Could be either. Let's go with proud and regal. Closed off posture. Very private person trying to stay warm likes the feel of a sweater. Private person. Probably going to be quite pissed off at me. Let's have a chat.
Mademoiselle Alphonse?
It's entirely possible.
Oui? I'm Malachi Rector. Perhaps someone from the American consulate told you I'd be getting in touch.
Oui, I did receive that message, but I did not realize it would be so soon. How did you find me?
Oh, it wasn't so difficult. May I join you?
Ignore the open safe.
Very well. What can I help you with?
Ooh, phasing fingers.
Tell me about yourself.
Me? I have no amusing stories to tell. My life is my family and my family's business. That is all.
That doesn't sound like an exciting life for a young woman.
Exciting is overrated.
Okay.
Tell me about your mother.
There is nothing to tell. She does very well.
Thanks to some pawned antiques, I take it?
Who told you that?
I visited your home. I could see for myself.
Nothing illegal has been done. I knew the antiques were being sold. I do not wish to discuss it.
Malachi, you're just pissing her off.
Tell me about your father.
Henri Alphonse is a well-respected man. You can ask anyone in France.
How is the state of the Alphonse family business?
Up the creek.
That is a very personal question.
That bad, is it? You're here with Etienne.
Yes.
The same Etienne whose business partners with your father?
Yes.
Yes. What about it?
Isn't Etienne a little old for you? Then again, your fiancé, Gérard de Villiers, he was not a young man either, was he?
How could that be any possible business of yours, Mr. Rector?
I'm completely lacking in any social boundaries. I'm just warning you now.
Where is Etienne now?
He had some business calls to make. He is very dedicated.
Mm-hmm.
What is your relationship with Etienne?
You can see what kind of place this is. Surely you can guess.
She doesn't sound keen.
I'd like to discuss your family finances.
How did you get that?
Does it matter? The point is, I have it.
Everything will be repaid. Every debt my father has, I made sure of it. There is no reason for the police to get involved.
Hello.
And how will it be taken care of?
Etienne Angy. He will cover the debt, and more besides.
That's very generous of him.
We are to be wed. Naturally, he would not allow my family to be ruined.
Your father ruined the family fortune? That must have been quite a trick. I thought it was an empire.
My grandfather made mistakes as well. But my father, he's ill. He has an addiction to gambling.
Oh.
I hope you will not feel the need to make that public. Our name is all I have left.
I'm not interested in gossip.
I will, however, dig for it.
So you intend to save the family business by marrying your father's business partner?
Etienne is an intelligent and successful man. It works out well for everyone.
Someone's not marrying for love.
You're marrying Etienne? Isn't he your father's age?
He is 55. It does not matter. Passionate love, it fades. My parents' marriage taught me that. Being married to Etienne will suit me very well.
I've heard you have an interest in the Paris catacombs.
I am interested in French history. The catacombs are full of it.
Uh-huh. Have you heard of a 13th century French monk named Bénédicte de Montfroy?
No. Who was this man?
I wish I knew. Have you heard of Saint-Armand? He was a knight during the Crusades. Supposedly, he's buried in the catacombs.
I never heard of him. You should ask a cataphile.
A cataphile?
People who explore the mines under Paris illegally. It's kind of an urban sport.
Bingo.
Interesting.
As opposed to a catamite, which is something else altogether.
I'll leave you for now, mademoiselle.
Goodbye, Mr. Rector.
Yes. Hope you never come
I've
back.
I've learned enough about Caroline to complete my analysis.
So, first drug up. Yeah, she really is not friendly,
is
she?
I already know I'm trying to match Caroline to Livia Drusilla. I just need to see if she fits the pattern.
Okay. Engaged for a second time. So it's definitely not that. Not a match. Is a match. Interest in politics. Yes. Degree in economics. I'm inclined to say yes. Oh, wait. First engagement broken off only a few months in. Not really a match. Parents divorced over her father's infidelity. Not a match. Basically, this is not the woman we're looking for. That matches. Descended for... yep, that's fine. Engaged at 19, basically. Definitely not. Her family's financial status in a shambles, a situation only made salvageable by her upcoming marriage to her father's business partner. So yeah, she is not the woman we're looking for. Probably someone's going to try and assassinate her anyway, though. Meanwhile, back at the ranch. What the hell's a cataphile? Fair enough. Avoid if corpses creep you out.
Those last few data points have done it. Caroline is not a match for Livia Drusilla. I'll text Dexter and let him know.
There you go. Alessandra
Looks
Lorraine.
Like we're going to Zurich. But there's one more thing I want to research before I leave Paris.
Right. Just how many air miles is this guy making? I know someone with a cataphile tattoo.
I suppose I could fill Walker in on the investigation.
I could tell him, but you know, I don't necessarily want to.
Mr. Walker?
Yes, Mr. Rector?
About my investigation into Caroline Alphonse.
Yeah?
Caroline is not the one we're looking for. Dexter wants us to head to Zurich to look at another candidate.
I'm ready whenever you are, Mr. Rector. Listen, I appreciate the fact that you've told me more about this mission than you have to.
I've taken no oaths of silence.
Even so, I'm glad you trust me, at least that far. You asked about my family earlier. I think I mentioned I have one sister. She's married and lives in Ohio. My parents are alive, but we don't really speak. Haven't since I was in college.
Why not?
We have opposing views on a few minor things, like how I should live my life. I don't suppose you really give a rat's ass, but you asked, so that's how it is.
Thank you. That's all for now.
As you say, sir.
Mm-hmm. Saving the game. Right. I suspect you to be a cataphile.
Excuse me.
Yes?
I noticed your tattoo.
It's a special design, monsieur. I'm afraid I can't give you the name of the shop.
I don't want one.
Are you a cataphile?
You know this word.
I said it, didn't I? I'm looking for information.
What information is that?
Do you know how to find San Almar, the Knight of the Catacombs?
The skeleton? Yes, I know it.
Will you tell me?
Are you offering a reward?
Really?
You're not with the police, eh?
Do I look like a French policeman?
No. To find the knight, go down through the manhole cover in the alley near the Patisserie en Le Mans. You can't miss him.
Thank you.
Although it might be worth giving it a shot.
I've already learned all I need to from the barista.
Okay. Let's go catacomb diving.
That must be the entrance to the catacombs that the barista mentioned.
Don't strain yourself. Here, let me.
Okay.
You're welcome.
I don't suppose you have a source of light.
Other than my sunny disposition? No, not on me.
Okay.
Who is that?
San Almar, the Knight of the Catacombs.
Never heard of him.
Neither had I until recently. He was associated with Benedict de Montfroy, a medieval monk who wrote a treatise on the Mobius theory.
Huh. Interesting.
Right. I love the whole walking out of the wall thing.
The skulls and bones on this wall have letters on them. Interesting.
Okie dokie.
This must be the skeleton of San Almar. He's still dressed like a crusade knight, sword and all.
And apparently he was caught mid-phase.
He's been here for hundreds of years. It would be tactless of me to disturb him now.
Now you're worried about tact.
That's a crusade shield. This must have something to do with San Almar.
Oh boy. Do we have any bees? Okay. Okie dokie. Can I analyze this? Prius mori quam fidam fallere. Thank you. So, go away. Where's Prius? I need an us. Prius. Mori quam. I'm blind. Skibidi. Which one's the ossis fish? Quam. Freedom. I'm missing.
San Alman.
Okie dokie. How funky. Oh, I see a cutscene.
How interesting. That must be a portrait of Saint-Armand. How interesting.
Oh, okay. Can you take a photo of it?
That's Saint-Armand.
He's the skeleton guy, right? Who was he?
Okay, standing next to your old skeleton.
Mr. Rector? Come on, let's get you back to the hotel.
Oh, this isn't going well. And of course his drugs aren't his drugs because somebody nicked them. Welcome to Tripsville. Yeah, just kick the door in, you know you want to. The bleeding from the eyeballs. This isn't trippy enough. You're holding a knife to his throat.
Yes. Tired.
I'm just gonna pass out now. This isn't awkward at all.
Thank you.
My god. Did he just say thank you?
You're welcome. Okay, so Zurich, here we go.
Mr. Rector, Mr. Walker, my name is Gustav. Welcome to the Lorraine Estate. We are so pleased to be hosting guests from the U.S. Embassy for tonight's soiree.
Thank you.
I understand you came straight from the airport. You will want to rest and bathe. The other guests won't be arriving for a few hours.
Hi, Boris.
Do you mind if we look around first?
If you like, please, enjoy yourselves.
Look at this place. I should really change. Good thing Dexter sent us those tuxes.
Later. I want to get as much information on Alessandra as I can before the other guests arrive.
Yes, sir.
Alessandra Lorraine is the next candidate for Livia Drusilla. I need to investigate her to see if she's a match or not.
Okay, so I only have 4 data points so far. She's the right descent. Nobility both sides. Married to a 47-year-old man at 21. Kindred spirit in his new bodyguard, who's the blonde he's wandering around with, who also may be an archetype. Well, let's face it, as of last chapter, we now know he's an archetype of the Protector. of the chap that Malachi is a reincarnation of. It's all slightly wafty, a bit new agey, but actually quite interesting. The data points thing seems to be, the actual final analysis ones that you've got the issue with, Fish? The points at which the patterns match up. Unusually handsome is related to me. No. I think self-absorbed or hide for his looks. Let's go with self-absorbed. Oh, yes, definitely self-absorbed. Overactive hands. Who also may be an archetype, well, let's face it, as of last chapter, we now know he's an archetype of the protector of the chap that Malachi is a reincarnation of. It's all slightly wafty, a bit new agey, but actually quite interesting. The data points thing seems to be, the actual final analysis ones that you've got the issue with, Fish? The points at which the patterns match up. Unusually handsome is related to me. No. I think self-absorbed or hide for his looks. Let's go with self-absorbed. Oh, yes, definitely self-absorbed. Overactive hands. Greedy. Gustav is self-absorbed and seductive. He aspires to be more than a family butler and is willing to use his good looks to get ahead. There's two types of analysis. There's this one, which is the little, I suppose, thumbnail sketches, which give you insight into people and things. And then there's the full-blown data point analysis, which I will show you, because I should have one on the books. Happy birthday, Fishy! Oop, wrong one. So, David Walker, this is your bodyguard. Right, so I've analysed him, but while in inconclusive, but while in the Paris catacombs observing the tomb of Saint-Armand, I experienced a visual hallucination of the knight overlaying Walker. Could he be Saint-Armand? I hope he is, because otherwise this is a really weird story. Otherwise, this is the woman I'm here to analyse. I haven't met her yet, so this is all I know about her. And I'm trying to determine whether or not she matches the pattern of somebody called Livia Drusilla, who was the wife of Augustus. Essentially, you've got people who are trying to manipulate history by putting the right people in the right places. Well, I'm hoping that the whole burned at the stake thing is not going to be in my future. He made it out, so maybe Montfort did. Okay. So, her husband is descended from the Lorraines. So that's a match. Her family and her husband's family are among the wealthiest in Europe. She came from a very wealthy ancient family, yep. Descended from her father's side on from the Habsburgs and the Bernadottes. Two families of old European nobility. Yep, matches. Married young. So far, yes, matches down the line. It is an epic bromance. It really is. We know that Malachi is effectively bisexual. I say effectively. I'm not convinced he actually fancies humans. He's just odd. And we have no knowledge of what Walker's preferences are. So. Gustav, talk to me. Now I know things about you.
Might I have a word, Gustav?
As you wish.
When the embassy contacted you, perhaps they mentioned that I might need some information.
I am here to provide anything you need, Mr. Rector. Within a reason.
Malachi is a historical analyst. Primary business is dealing in antiques, at which he is very good at judging forgeries.
Tell me about Alessandra.
She is lovely, charming. What would you like to know?
Does she have any hobbies or interests?
She enjoys many things in life. I'm sure she would be happy to tell you herself.
Uh-huh.
Tell me about Carl Lorraine.
Everyone in the household is very fond of Herr Lorraine. It is sad that he is not in the best of health.
Oh? What's the matter with Herr Lorraine?
It is not my place to say, but as you can see, he is well enough to have these parties in the house, for Alessandra's sake.
Yeah, trust you as far as I could comfortably throw you.
You said the party tonight is for Alessandra's sake. What do you mean exactly?
Well, Alessandra, being a beautiful young woman, naturally loves parties. But some of Herr Lorraine's politics have not been well received. So they entertain at home and have trusted friends here.
Are you saying the couple is not welcome in society?
Oh, no, no. They are, after all, Lorraine's. Only it is easier to control the guest list in one's own home, and Herr Lorraine is too polite to argue in public.
Yeah, I'm not entirely sure that's flattering to you.
Thank you, Gustav.
You are most welcome.
Malachi is a fundamentally unlikable git. He suffers from major trust issues after his mother was mauled to death by a lion while returning from meeting her lover when he was 7. It's sort of spiraled from there. And he's hyper-intelligent.